Hello friends, welcome back to another video from Shomus Biology. In this video lecture, we are going to talk about competitive ELISA assay. If you are new to ELISA and don't know what ELISA test is, then I will recommend you to watch the video on ELISA test in my channel. There are two videos, the new video with the board, that's what you can watch. We have been talking about the basics of ELISA test, the types of ELISA test, and we have discussed about the direct ELISA, indirect ELISA, sandwich ELISA. In this video lecture, we are going to talk about the competitive ELISA test or competitive ELISA assay. Okay, so what happens in competitive ELISA? Okay, and why we call it as a competitive ELISA? Because you know the basics of ELISA assay depends on the antigen-antibody interaction, and you need to have a basic understanding of this immunological technique, otherwise you cannot get what I am about to say. So this antigen-antibody interaction is very specific. That means there is an antibody and there is a specific antigen with which the antibody can bind, and this interaction is very specific and this interaction is targeted. Okay, it's a, like a lock and key fit. And now what we are trying to find out, we can either find out the presence of antigen in the patient sample, or we can try to find out the presence of antibody or the presence of antibody in the patient sample, either of that. In competitive ELISA, what we are trying to do is that we are trying to find out the presence of specific antigen in the body of the patient. So we are trying to find out the antigen. Okay, and let's assume the antigen is antigen A, a specific antigen that we are trying to find out. So how this process works? Let me draw wells, two wells. Okay, one from the patient 1 we are looking at. This is from the patient 2 we are looking at, and there are different stages of this ELISA assay. I'll be talking about that. I'll walk you through that while I explain. So these are these two wells. What are wells? Wells are small compartments in a plate known as microtiter plate. And in this well, the bottom of the well is designed in such a way that it can hold onto specific antibody. Because we are trying to find out this antigen, we are trying to find out the targeted antigen, we are using an antibody against the targeted antigen. Okay. So what we do here is that let's draw the antibody, the targeted antibody present to the bottom of the well. Okay, done. Targeted antibody are present to the bottom of the well. This is the structure of the well. This is the very first step. Then what we do, we add the sample. See, first is the fixing of the antigen or antibody to the bottom. We have done that. Then the addition of, so normally the test kits, we call it test kits, they already come with this kind of structures. And then we have addition of specimen. We add the specimen from patient 1 and patient 2 in two different wells, two separate wells. Now this patient specimen may or may not contain our target antigen that is in blue color. Okay, so let's say patient 1 contains this, but patient 2 does not contain any of this, okay, any of the components. These are the specimens added, and our target here is the antigen A, means this one, okay, which is present in the left side well but not present in the right side well. Then what will happen? Then what we know, we allow this antigen antibody to interact, and we know what happens in the left hand well. Yes, this one, the specimen sample, if patient sample contains the antigen, then it will bind to the antibody. But in competitive ELISA, there is a change, because till this point is very similar to the sandwich ELISA. It's very similar to other ELISA technique. But the competitive ELISA are differing, because at this point, after the addition of specimen in all the other cases, there is a washing stage. But here, there is no washing stage. There is a bypass stage, and this stage is the addition of reagent or addition of antigen. What antigen? Antigen which is acting as a reagent here. And what antigen? Again, the specific same antigen that we are trying to detect from the patient's specimen. Same antigen, remember, we are trying to detect that antigen A. So the reagent will be antigen A linked with enzyme, that is the reagent. So let me write here the structure of the reagent. The reagent we are talking about here is antigen A with the blue color. Let me write antigen A, which is linked with the enzyme, linked with enzyme. Okay, so that will be denoted here with the let's say that I'll denote here with the help of green color, like that. Okay, So we add our reagent, means enzyme linked antigen. Okay, we add enzyme linked antigen is also added. Then we allow them to all bind to the antibody which is present in the well. So generally it's not step by step, actually addition of specimen and reagent done almost together at the same time. We add the specimen along with our reagent, remember, along with our reagent at the same time, because our intention here is to allow this two types of antigen. One is the antigen from the patient specimen and second one is our reagent antigen, to compete each other to bind with the fixed antibody to the bottom of the well, because they will compete. Why will they compete? Because both of them are specific towards the antibody which is soldered, which is fixed to the bottom of the well. Both of them will compete for it, compete for the winding. They mean to compete for the winding. Okay, so this process works like this. And afterwards what happens, they will compete for the winding, right? And now imagine, who will win this competition? Because we add reagent in a specific amount, we know what amount we have added. If the sample, the patient sample contains more antigen than the reagent, okay, so let me write it. If patient's antigen is more than the reagent antigen, then what happens? Patient antigen will bind to the antibody. But if patient antigen is less in number than reagent antigen, then patient antigen will be less in number associated to the antibody, right? So what will happen after this is done? Once this is done, we allow them to bind. After some time passes, we do a washing stage. Now we'll wash off any of this excess thing. Okay, we'll wash it off. So what happens if we wash off everything here? We know that because in the second well, this well, the right hand well, there was no patient antigen, so all the antigens that are bound will be the reagent antigen. Reagent antigen is in green color, bound, all are reagent antigen. But here there will be reagent antigen and there will be patient antigen. As per this picture, the reagent antigen is more than the patient antigen. So there will be more binding of reagent antigen and less binding of patient antigen in this case. Let's say this is a reagent antigen, and there will be here a patient antigen. This is done. What happens? Generally, in case of sandwich ELISA, there was a secondary antibody and washing and all. But now in this case, what we know, that this reagent antigen is already associated with the enzyme. So what we add here, we directly go to the addition of substrate. We add the let's take a different color here, denoting substrate. We add a substrate. If we add substrate, as we know that enzymes are present here, right? So enzyme will convert substrate into a colored product. Colored product. This is also colored product. But the intensity of this color is more, because all of this antigens which are associated with the antibody are enzyme linked. So very high intensity of color. Where in this case, due to the presence of target or specimen antigen, specimen antigen lacks enzyme, so it cannot convert substrate into product. So the color will be formed, but the intensity of the color in this well, left hand side well, will be less intensity. Here will be high intensity, right? And now think of this. Now it's very important point, okay? Think of this. The higher the intensity, so here what we can see, the intensity is less. If the patient sample contains more antigen, if they contain more blue, then what happened? The intensity will be even lesser, right? So the more the antigen, the more patient antigen is present in the very first place, the less the intensity. The more the patient antigen, the less the intensity. That's how we can correlate. Here there was no patient antigen, that's why we have the highest intensity. That's why we keep this as a reference, we keep this as a control. So always, whenever So always, whenever we are using competitive ELISA, we run a control with 100% reagent antigen to find out the maximum intensity possible, and it compare the, because this intensity, the color intensity can be quantifiable. So we know that quantity, that if there is no single specimen antigen is present, what is the intensity, and then we find out the actual intensity of the from the well that actually carries some patient antigen, and by comparing the two we can easily find out which well contains more patient antigen or less patient antigen. That gives us a reference value, a scale to tell whether the antigen level is high or antigen level is low in patient's body, and depending upon this antigen level we can comment whether the disease is at its peak or it's already done or weakened or just started. We can tell about all these things from the level of antigen of from a patient sample. So that's all about competitive ELISA. Okay, so competitive ELISA, why the term competitive is given, because in competitive ELISA antigens are competing, one from the patient antigen and second one is the reagent antigen. They are competing with each other to bind with the specific antibody which is fixed to the bottom of the well. Okay, so that's all about the competitive ELISA test or competitive ELISA assay. If you like this video, please hit the like button, share this video with your friends and subscribe to this channel to get to know about more and almost all biological topics that are possible. And if you like to know all the other types of ELISA assays like direct ELISA, indirect ELISA, sandwich ELISA and also the basics of ELISA test, then I'll always recommend you to watch the whole ELISA lecture series which is also present in this channel. So that's all for today. I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.